So now that we know what polynomials are, and we also know how to combine like terms, let's go ahead and put that together to add and subtract polynomials. So in this problem, I'm asked to add this polynomial to the second polynomial here. And what you want to do is you want to start off by looking for like terms. So I see I have a 3x squared and a negative 7x squared. Those would be like terms. So before we do that, what we'll do is we'll go ahead and we'll drop the parentheses. And we can do that because it's addition right here. So I'm going to write 3x squared minus 2x plus 5. Okay, and then now plus a negative, that's the same as subtraction. So minus 7x squared plus x minus 6. And now when you go to combine like terms, that is the 3x squared and the negative 7x squared, notice how I'm mentally thinking of the negative is going with the 7. So I'm thinking to myself, okay, 3 plus negative 7, and that gives me negative 4x squared. So you combine like terms by adding the coefficients. So you combine like terms, as we've talked about before, by adding the coefficients. And like terms are those terms where not only do they have the same variable, but the same exponent as well. Okay, so x squared and x squared. Next two like terms would be the two terms containing x, right? So a negative 2x, well, the coefficient is a negative 2, and a positive 1. So add the coefficients, negative 2 and positive 1 is negative 1. So it's negative 1x, which we just write as minus x. And then finally, the constant terms, 5 plus negative 6 is negative 1. Okay, and this would be our answer. Okay, let's try another one now, but involving subtraction. Okay, so once again, we have one polynomial take away another. And what's different about subtraction is that you have to distribute this negative sign. So we think of this like a negative 1 here, and then we take that negative 1 and we distribute it over the terms in the polynomial that follows. This polynomial is unaffected. So you can just simply, for the first polynomial, you can drop those parentheses. So you're going to have x squared minus x minus 2. Okay, ready? Negative 1 times negative 1 is a positive 1, so plus x squared. Negative 1 times positive x is negative x. And finally, negative 1 times negative 5 is positive 5. Okay, now we're ready to combine like terms. So a 1x squared and a 1x squared is a 2x squared. And a negative 1x and another negative 1x is a negative 2x. And then finally, negative 2 and positive 5 is positive 3. Okay, let's try one more that's a little more challenging now. One that involves fractions. Okay, let's add these two polynomials together. So, once again, because it's addition right here, I can once again just simply drop the parentheses, and I'm going to get, well, let's see, 1 half x squared minus 2 thirds x plus 1. Okay, plus 1 third x squared minus 1 half x, and then minus 2 thirds. Okay, now at this stage, I have noticed that students are most successful when they approach this these types of problems with fractions in the following way. So what we're going to do is, once again, we're going to combine like terms, right? The 1 half x squared, and we're going to add to that the 1 third x squared. But what's tricky about this problem, of course, is that the coefficients are fractions. Now, if somebody gave you this, right, off to the side, if they gave you 2x plus 5x, well, right away, you'd know that that was 7x, right? Now, nothing would be wrong if the person wanted to take a little extra time and say, oh, I need to take 2 and add it to 5, right, and then multiply that by x. After all, you can do this in your head, but it's fine if somebody wants to write this and they say, oh, okay, 2 plus 5 is 7x. Now we're going to take that same approach with fractions. So I'm going to add the 1/2 and the 1/3 together, but I'm going to put those in parentheses and I'm going to put the x squared on the outside, so it gives me a chance to focus on adding the 1/2 and the 1/3. So let's do that. It's going to be parentheses, add the 1/2 to the 1/3. Okay, and then I'm going to have the x squared on the outside of that. And we're going to do the same thing for the next terms, right? Now the next terms contain x. So instead of the x squared being on the outside, it's going to be x for those. Now remember, the negative goes with the coefficient that follows. So the negative is actually part of this coefficient, right? So it's -2/3, and here it's going to be -1/2. Now when you play this game, that is what I'm doing right now, how I'm, you know, putting the coefficients in parentheses, what you want to do is you want to separate the clusters, if you will, by an addition sign. So the addition sign is necessary when you want the negative to go with the coefficient. And so it's going to look like this, plus parentheses, okay, -2/3, right? And then the next one's going to be -1/2. Okay, both of those times, or all of that, I should say, times x. So do you see what happened? I said, let's put the negative with the 2/3 and the negative with the 1/2. And I want to put those in parentheses and then multiply that by the x. But you have to put addition there to separate it from what you had before. And likewise for the last one, right? It's going to be plus, well, now what am I going to add together? Positive 1, so 1, and then -2/3. Now you might say, well, this is a lot of work, right? Why would I go through that extra work? Because adding fractions together can be a little bit tricky, right? You have to make sure that you get a common denominator, and sometimes that can be a little technical. So this allows you the extra time just to focus on that step. Okay, so what do we do here? We say, well, we know how to add fractions, right? Common denominator, it's going to be common denominator of 6. So I'm going to multiply top and bottom by 3. So I'm going to get 3/6. This one's going to be, well, top and bottom by 2, so it's going to be 2/6, right, times x squared. Same thing for the next two fractions. Well, it's going to be 6 again, right? So top and bottom by 2, so it's going to be -4/6, top and bottom by 3, so -3/6, times x. And then for this last one, well, remember, 1 is the same as 1/1. Right? So you multiply top and bottom by 3. So it's 3/3 -2/3. And then I go ahead and say, let's go ahead and add our fractions together, right? So 3/6 plus 2/6 is 5/6 x squared. And for the next one, well, it's going to be -4 take away 3, which is -7/6. Now, nobody writes plus -7/6. You can just write minus 7/6 x. And for the last one, it's going to be, let's see, well, plus, let's see, 3/3 take away 2/3 is 1/3, so it's going to be positive 1/3. So initially this technique took a little extra time, but it was super easy once we got it down to this stage, and that's what we're looking for. We're looking for easy and clear techniques. Okay, hope that helps.